Hello, DJ at Fitness in Motion. I've been professional personal training for almost 25 years. And today, I want to show you tips and tricks on how to get the most out of training with dumbbells. So let's get to it. Okay, off we go with our dumbbell tips and tricks. So what we need to understand when we're working with dumbbells is they only work directly against gravity. What that means for weightlifting is we have to know at which point the intended muscle groups are actually fighting gravity. For lateral side raises, which is an exercise that works my shoulders, my medial delts, I'm not feeling much at the bottom of this rep. It's not until I start to lift up against gravity that my shoulders actually kick in. So if your shoulder raises are coming all the way down to here, there's not much happening in my shoulders right now. It's not until I get up beyond that point and start fighting gravity that I actually feel this in my shoulders. So I want you to focus on the muscles you're trying to work and make sure it's those muscles that are fighting the gravity. If I'm coming down here and I'm going from here to here, nothing's happening in my shoulders. It's not until I start to lift. So when you do shoulder side raises, front raises only come down here. Same thing on the front. I'm here, I'm lifting, but I don't come all the way down to a resting point because there's nothing happening here. It's when I lift and I come down to here, so I'm always fighting gravity with the intended muscle group. Okay, continuing with dumbbells, we're going to use biceps and understand the gravitational work for biceps. So again, when I turn, when I'm doing a biceps curl, whether it's a palms up curl, a hammer curl, or even a reverse curl, no matter, when I'm at the bottom of the rep, when I'm all the way out here, nothing's happening in my biceps right now. My biceps are not under tension. It's not until I get my biceps against gravity that I'm actually feeling the biceps holding the weight. So do not come all the way down to a resting point. There shouldn't be any rest for your biceps. Time under tension. So when I come up, I'm getting a flex. I'm coming down, but not all the way down. And back up again. And that way my biceps are under tension the entire time. At the top of the rep, same thing applies. When I get up here, my biceps are no longer responsible for holding this weight. It's more shoulders. So don't come all the way up and don't go all the way down. Yes, go all the way up to feel a flex, but make sure that flex happens and occurs in your biceps, not in your shoulders. So when you come up, get to the peak contraction point of your biceps. And when you come down, don't go to a resting point. It's effective range of motion, not full range of motion. Make sure those muscles are working against gravity. Now we're on to triceps. So when we're working with dumbbells and we want to make sure that it's the triceps that are doing the work during this activity, we have to know when the triceps get involved against gravity and when it's another muscle or momentum. So for triceps kickbacks, I'll demonstrate right here. When I start the lift from here to here, my triceps are doing nothing. I'm literally swinging the weight and I feel nothing in my triceps. It's not until I start to go against gravity to start to lift the weight that I start to feel my triceps flex. When I come down, I'm not going to come up to here because it's not a biceps exercise. When I come up, I'm actually working my biceps. If you're trying to work triceps, go back until you feel a flexion point, come down just to here, and right back up again. That's where the short head of the triceps are going to be stimulated the most. When I come down here, again, nothing's happening. I'm not lifting. It's not until I start to arc up till I feel it in my triceps. So always know what you're trying to work and at what point that area starts to work. So the last tip I want to show you when we're doing dumbbell work is momentum and swinging. We've got to get those out of your program, okay? Don't swing the weights, because when you're using momentum, we're not doing anything for the muscles. So no matter what the exercise is, in this case, an upright row, if I'm actually lifting up slow and controlled, I'm gonna feel the intended muscle groups. If I throw the weights up, and I've seen this so often in every gym, is people come up and they, not only do they swing it, they actually dip their body down so they don't have to go up as high. And there's some crazy gyration that happens in their body and they call it an exercise. It's not. It's an exercise on how to get hurt. It's not an exercise that's gonna give you any benefit. So when you do any exercise whatsoever, it's slow, it's controlled, there's a contraction, you stay in the area where the muscles you're trying to work are actually doing the lift, and you're not just throwing weights around. All right, so make sure there's no swinging and no momentum in your training. So when you're working with dumbbells, make sure that we're using the muscles we're trying to work against gravity, we're spending the entire time under tension and we don't swing or use any momentum when we're training. I hope this helps. If you liked our video today, subscribe right here to our channel and click here for our next video. Thanks so much and best of luck.